Good morning, everyone, and welcome. I'm Cameron Friesen, a member of the Legislative Assembly for Morden-Winkler constituency, Minister of Justice and Attorney General. I'm very pleased to be joined this morning with MP Terry Duguid, with the Minister of Central Service, Reg Helwer, and the member for Brandon West, Mayor Martin Harder in the city of Winkler, remotely the Reeve of the RM of Stanley, Morris Olofsson, and also the MLA for Borderland, Josh Ginter, and also Doyle Pinuk, who is the member of the Legislative Assembly for Turtle Mountain. Thank you, everyone, for joining us this morning for an important announcement. I want to acknowledge the contributions of Treaty 1 land to the project that we are involved in today. I'm so pleased to be able to moderate for an important announcement. I would like to now introduce Terry Duguid, Member of Parliament for Winnipeg South, on behalf of the Honourable Catherine McKenna, Minister of Infrastructure and Communities, to deliver remarks on behalf of the Government of Canada.
Well, good morning, and thank you, Minister Friesen, for the introduction. It's a great pleasure for me to attend this important announcement today with Manitoba Ministers Helwer and yourself and Mayor Harder and other officials that are on the line with us today. And first, I'd like to acknowledge that I am joining you from my home in Winnipeg in Treaty 1 territory and the homeland of the Métis Nation. I'd also like to say our country has heavy hearts today with the discovery of the unmarked graves of 151 children in Saskatchewan, not far from the Manitoba border, and that we grieve with the people of Kawasis First Nation and Indigenous peoples across the country. And while we are a beautiful country, we have to acknowledge these terrible parts of our history. Folks, the COVID-19 pandemic has certainly been unprecedented and challenging for many across the country. It also has been amazing to see how many departments, orders of government, and agencies have pulled together for Canadians and the people of Manitoba. As we continue on the road to recovery, we have an opportunity to build the future we want for ourselves and generations of Canadians to come. We need to be ambitious and build back better by making smart investments so that communities can quickly recover and become more resilient in the long term. The Government of Canada is working closely with provinces and territories, municipalities, and all stakeholders to get projects built quickly, projects that will make a positive difference in the lives of Canadians and will move the country forward. Building healthy communities starts with investing in essential services, which is exactly why we are here today. And I am so pleased to announce that the Government of Canada is investing more than $25.2 million for phase one of the Winkler-Stanley Morden Regional Wastewater Treatment System. This funding will support a new mechanical wastewater treatment facility in Winkler, two new lift stations in Stanley, and upgrades to the first of two lagoon cells. In addition, 45 kilometers of piping will connect the communities of Schenzenfeld and Rheinfeld to the Regional Wastewater Treatment System. The project will make the system more efficient and cost-effective for municipalities and ensure the wastewater system meets both federal and provincial requirements. The Winkler-Stanley-Morden region is one of the fastest growing in Manitoba, so it's important that critical infrastructure like this wastewater treatment system can handle community growth and do so in an environmentally sustainable way. As some of you may know, I have always been a strong advocate for community building and environmental protection, both of which will be positively impacted by this investment. Despite the recent challenges caused by COVID-19, this region will continue to grow and expand, creating economic opportunities which attract new families, services, and businesses to the area. And with Canada's infrastructure plan, we're investing thousands of projects, creating jobs across the country and contributing to cleaner, more resilient, and more inclusive communities. In fact, since November 2015, the federal government has approved and announced more than $919 million in investments in 228 infrastructure projects across Manitoba to strengthen local economies and improve people's quality of life. Just summing up, Minister Friesen, I'm proud of the strong collaboration between federal, provincial, and municipal partner, which has been key to securing this important project and today's announced funding. The pandemic has been very difficult for Manitobans and for all Canadians. As we see continued hope through the vaccine rollout, the Government of Canada continues to support businesses and the local economy by investing in smart, shovel-ready projects that directly benefit communities. And as I've seen on a daily basis and appreciate most from Manitobans, let's continue to be caring towards one another and get through this difficult time. Thank you. Back to you, Mr. Minister.
MP Duguid, thank you for your remarks. Thank you for your partnership through you to the minister. Thank you for helping us to get to this day. I know it wasn't that terribly long ago when MP Duguid joined Mayor Harder and I and others on the stage at the Winkler Senior Center when you were newly minted in your role. We look forward to having you back to our community to see the ongoing growth that's taking place. At this time, I want to call upon the Honourable Reg Helwer, Minister of Central Services, to deliver remarks on behalf of the Government of Manitoba.
Thank you, Mr. Friesen, and thank you, Terry, both of you, for your land acknowledgements and your contributions to this project. I guess I should start by saying congratulations to the Montreal Canadiens and to a Brandon-born product that Joel Edmondson, that plays for the Canadiens, of course. He's got one Stanley Cup ring and gunning for another one here. Sad to see another Brandon-born or raised product, Zach Whitecloud, didn't make it through with the Golden Knights with General Manager Kelly McCrimmon, but I'm sure we'll be well represented by Montreal and by Joel. So good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us virtually this morning, and it is indeed a very exciting day for the region. Manitoba is pleased to announce our contribution of $21 million to the Winkler-Stanley-Morden Regional Wastewater Treatment System Phase 1 project. By working together with all three levels of government, we are able to make large investments in local infrastructure. These investments ensure that Manitobans will have access to modern and reliable services. The Manitoba government continues to deliver strategic investments in community infrastructure to help facilitate growth and improve the quality of life in the province. By improving wastewater management, the City of Winkler and service areas will be better able to meet wastewater regulations and provide a cleaner environment to the area's rapidly growing population. The new water treatment infrastructure will provide quality water to existing residences while allowing for long-term development and growth in the community. By working together, Manitoba can lead the way in attracting world-class industry to the province and further job creation while simultaneously making the province greener and cleaner. Thank you to our federal partners, the City of Winkler, Mayor Martin Harder, and the arm of Stanley with Reeve Morris Olofsson for their contributions to this important project funded through the Investing in Canada Infrastructure Program. Collaborating with our partners on projects like this allows us to continue to make improvements to infrastructure across the province, and we're working together to make Manitoba a better, even better place to live in. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister Helwer, for your comments and for your support and for your leadership. I know Minister Helwer well. He has really seized this file. He cares deeply about these projects. He has worked tirelessly to get us to this day on behalf of the province. And I thank you for your continued leadership and partnership in being able to bring announcements like this. So thank you, Minister Helwer. At this point in time, I want to acknowledge and call upon the Mayor of Winkler, Martin Harder, on behalf of the municipal partners to bring greetings. Martin, please.
Thank you, Minister Friesen, for this opportunity, Minister Helwer, and Minister Duguid for your part in making sure that this project comes to reality. So on behalf this morning of Reeve Olofsson, who is joining us remotely, I just want to say thank you for the opportunity to partner with you on this project to make Winkler and Stanley and Morden a better place to live because of the environmental impact that the wastewater has, and the ability to be able to treat this will actually allow us to grow beyond where we are today. Today is truly a landmark announcement. This will allow an already hot economy and a growing economy to grow, expand, and contribute not only to the local economy of the Pembina Valley, but also to the province of Manitoba, and also to the country of Canada. So together, we make this place better. We need partners in order to be able to do it productively and to do it effectively. And today, I just want to say and acknowledge the contribution of the province, the federal government, and the municipalities in question to make this project a reality. So thank you very much. We will continue to grow. We will continue to contribute and make this a better place to live.
Thank you, Mayor Harder, for those remarks. As the local MLA for Morden-Winkler in the Manitoba Legislature, I also have to say, and I underscore Martin's points, that we are bullish in Morden-Winkler and Stanley, and indeed in southern Manitoba, about our growth, about the things that continue to draw people to our area, job prospects, a strong manufacturing sector, a great quality of life. We've seen great growth over the past number of years, but with great growth comes great responsibility, and part of that responsibility is to plan for the future. And I know that it is tireless hours that our municipal leaders have put in. We've had many meetings behind closed doors, but today is a good day, a day when we can put all of this struggle and the setbacks and the incremental progress behind us and say we are here and we're going forward securing, as we've all said this morning, a better infrastructure, a better for the environment, and infrastructure that will help to secure our strong growth in the future. That's the end of our official program for today. At this point in time, we want to turn things over to our moderator, who will facilitate questions from the media.
Thank you, Minister. A reminder to our reporters on the line, you will have one preliminary and one follow-up question. Up first this morning from the Winnipeg Sun, James.
Good morning, everyone. Question for Mr. Helwer. Can you please talk about the current state of wastewater treatment in the area and why the investment is necessary from a technical perspective?
Thanks for the question, and Martin may be able to answer that a little bit better than I can, because they're the proponents of the project. We've known that many areas of Manitoba are challenged not only with water but with wastewater treatment, and this is one of those areas, especially with the rapid growth that we're seeing, that there are cautions on how much the current plant can sustain.
Thank you. And is there an estimate in terms of the number of jobs that could be created
in the construction of the facility? Well, until we go to tender, that's a little bit unknown of what we might create for jobs. But these are large facilities that are being built and pipelines, and they will certainly have a tremendous impact on the area.
Thank you.
From the Winnipeg Free Press, Dylan.
Hi there. Thanks for taking our questions. The project coming today, it's being announced much later than other ISIT Coster announcements in other provinces. But I'd like to hear from Mr. Duguid, Minister Friesen, and especially Mayor Harder. Who's to blame for the holdup in getting this funding flowing?
You want to speak to them?
Well, we'll let Mayor Harder go with that. Go ahead, Mayor.
You know, there's a saying that says that every project that's worth doing is worth doing well. And I think this may be one of those. If the project would have been built right in the beginning when we started it, and I look back at the dates back in 2011, 2012, when the discussion started taking place, somewhere around 2015, 16, we had a moratorium on further subdivisions because of the fact that we had exceeded our capacity on our lagoon system. And we knew full well that there was a issue that needed to be dealt with. So it's a long time coming, and I believe it's like four governments later. So the programs have changed. But honestly, I believe the program has got better as we have refined it again and again. So we're just grateful we're here.
Does Terry want to say something?
Yeah, I was on... I was on mute there, but I think we would all like to see our infrastructure projects proceed apace and to be done quickly, but as Mayor Harder mentioned, to be done right. I know there are a number of initiatives on the horizon. The North End Treatment Plant has been a priority for all levels of government, municipal, provincial, federal. My understanding is that discussions are going well. There's good news in the offing, and projects like the one we're announcing today, the North End Treatment Plant, of course, are all going to contribute to improving water quality in Lake Winnipeg, which is such a precious resource for all Manitobans. So that's a bit of a reflection I have on your question.
And Minister Friesen, I'm sorry, do you have a response there? But that's not my follow-up question. I'm still on the first question.
Sure. I would be happy to add the following and say that, as other persons have just stated, this is a very complex project. It's enormous in scope. It takes time to get it right. We've gotten it right. We're very pleased to be here today.
And my second question is for Minister Friesen. Given the poor vaccination rates that we're seeing in Winkler and the RM of Stanley, why are you allowing the region to reopen with the rest of the province when they clearly haven't met the vaccination target? And Mayor Harder, do you have any thoughts on that?
I'll go first and say this. So to correct the record, the vaccination rate is improving. There's been an awful lot of hard work. I want to especially commend the local community and public health for forming the types of partnerships that are getting pop-up vaccine clinics all around our community. So we are seeing that improvement, and we need to see that improvement. As to your question, you're asking the wrong question. It is not local MLAs who set rules about reopening. That's the responsibility of public health. And we know that right now, public health is working very hard. We know that we've got a 4-3-2, one great summer reopening plan that Manitobans are eager to get on with. But of course, that plan will only go on as we continue to reach those targets because safety matters. So we're looking forward to getting back to normal. The vaccine rates are going up, and they must. And we will continue that good work to encourage vaccine to those groups and individuals who still may have hesitancy. Mayor Harder, over to you.
Thank you, Cameron. I think if I would reflect on where we are at today compared to where we were at in the beginning, there's been a huge change already in regards to the acceptance of the vaccine. I believe also that it's important not to regionalize the opening, and simply for the fact that initially when there was zero cases in Winkler and Winnipeg was totally bombarded with cases, we all closed down at the same time. I think we're in this together. We want to make sure that we stay a team and not start discriminating against certain areas because of, for some reason, the uptake isn't quite the same.
Our final reporter this morning from the Winkler Morden Voice, Lorne.
Thank you, everyone. I understand there may not be a lot of details about the project yet at this point, but what can be said at this point in terms of the possible timeline for when construction might start, any target date in mind for completion?
That's something that will be covered off when we issue the RFP, and we'll have close discussions with the individual companies and organizations that will respond to that. We obviously need to get this built in the ground as quickly as we can, but it's a challenging time, as I'm sure you know, working with pandemic restrictions, but we do know that the industry is hungry for work as well.
And Mayor Harder, would you also like to add to that?
Well, I can just maybe on a lighter side say I hope they're very hungry.
Well, perhaps Minister Friesen and Mayor Harder, just some further comments on what you see this doing for the greater region of Winkler-Morden in terms of advancing its development and growth.
Yeah, I would say the following, that this is a foundational project for us. Those who have watched closely our growth over the last 10, 15 years, and Lauren, I know you have, they have seen an extraordinary growth pattern in the area of Morden-Winkler, the RM of Stanley and surrounding areas. And that growth has to be managed. We are building schools. We are expanding roadways. We are planning and executing on other major infrastructure components, as the city of Winkler did only a number of years ago when they built a new reverse osmosis water treatment plant. But clearly, we will be a turtle in an aquarium if we don't get this wastewater project built. We will simply grow to the size we now have, and then we will be stuck. And so this is the gateway to future growth. This is the way we secure and provide confidence to business, to industry, to residential areas, and to families that this area will continue to be a leader in Manitoba. So, as I said, tremendous hard work to get here from everyone. This is a great example of partnership. I do thank Minister Helwer and others for their leadership, and of course, my local communities who have worked tirelessly on this. The municipality of Stanley, the city of Winkler, and working on their part of the project right now, the city of Morden. So kudos to everyone. This is the path forward. Mayor Harder, over to you for other comments.
I just wanted to say that the lifeblood of our community depends on water and wastewater. As you well know, we have discouraged wet industries from coming to this region simply because we don't have a water supply. I look at the recent restrictions as far as water is concerned in both in Morden as well as Winkler, as well as throughout the Pembina Valley. So we know that water is a precious commodity, and we know that we need to treat it with respect. And we need to also understand that we need to produce a wastewater that is totally clean environmentally, and that there will be multiple uses that maybe that can entail in the future. So it's an important project. It is a regional project. It is something that is necessary for the growth of the region, and I dare say necessary for the growth of the province of Manitoba.
Thank you, everyone. This concludes our media briefing.